Now, many people, like our first AD Gavin Booth here, many people prefer to break down the script by hand. I actually like using software for this process instead. The reason is because I do everything digitally. I write the script in Adobe Story, and I also use Story. Well, technically it's Story CC+. And I use that to break down the script and generate lists, make the schedule, a whole bunch of stuff. And I love having all this right here in one centralized place. And, you know, I also kind of like that it's stored in the cloud and I could access it from anywhere. And later we'll look at Shot Designer, which is my other go-to pre-production software tool. But for this tutorial and, you know, throughout this series, I'll be showing you how I do things in Adobe Story. But you can do a lot of this stuff in other software applications as well, like Celtics or, you know, the industry standard apps from Movie Magic or, you know, just with a good old pen and paper like Gavin does. But the concepts are the important thing to grasp here, and they're universal regardless of the method that you use. Now, as mentioned previously, I'm going to start by generating scene numbers for each slug line in my scene if I haven't done that already. So in Story, again, I just go to View, Numbering, and then choose Scene. You also want to check the numbering and make sure that they're numbered the way that you want them. In earlier versions of the script when I was doing stuff, I changed things around a little bit, deleted some things, and so the scene numbering was all messed up. So in those cases, I had to delete the numbering and start over. And you can do that in Story by going to the production menu, choosing manage scene numbers here. And then from this dialog, I clicked remove all scene numbers to clear out all the existing scene numbers and click OK. And then I come back to this dialog box again. And the second time, I chose assign scene numbers with the automatically assign option checked and the keep existing option unchecked. This kind of clears the slate and starts all over again. Now, again, you would never want to do this if you'd already started breaking down the script and already had assigned scene numbers. But if you just started this process and nobody else in the crew has seen those numbers yet and they haven't been used for anything, then you can totally change them so they make more sense if you want to. Now, if you'd like to follow along with me here and you have access to the exercise files here on lynda.com, I've provided the shooting script for the assurance in the Adobe Story file format, as well as PDF file format and the final draft format, which is the FDX file here. So you have a variety of formats in case you'd like to use another method besides Adobe Story to practice breaking this script down here. To bring the ASTX file into Story, you go to the File menu and choose Import as New Document and then select the ASTX file. Now, getting back to the task at hand here, after we've numbered our scenes, then we divide each page into eighths, which gives us 8 1-inch sections if we're working on paper. If we're here in Story, that process has already been done for us, as we can see here in the Scene Properties panel on the right-hand side, which is another big reason to use Story, because that process of dividing pages into eighths is super annoying to me from my experience. Now, the reason that we divide pages into eighths is so that we have a more specific gauge on the amount of material that we're planning to shoot on a given day. So in other words, if you told your crew that, hey, you know, we're shooting scenes 1, 4, and 5, that doesn't really say anything about how much you're planning to shoot that day. You know, is that a lot or a little bit? Who knows? But if you said, hey, we're planning on shooting 2 5/8 pages today, well, you know, that's something a crew can plan for. Oh, and that's another thing. When planning for a shoot, the page count is always rendered in eighths. So for example, 4/8 is never converted to a half. It's always 4/8. Now, if you're doing this on paper, you basically draw horizontal lines across the page vertically or fold each page of the script in half a few times to divide the pages into eighths, you know, whatever works for you. Next step, I actually want to go through the entire script and figure out, you know, what props we need, what wardrobe pieces we need, basically anything that we need to buy, rent, or borrow, or that other department heads need to be aware of. To do this in Story, I select a word that represents something, let's say a prop in this case, and then I tag it as such. I tag it as a prop. So right here at the top of page 1 in the script where it says staff, referring to the staff that Cordea has in her hand, I'll select that word. And this is a prop that our art department should know about. So then just go over here to the tags panel on the right hand side, and next to the props tag, I'll click add. And then in this dialog box, click add again to confirm. And now the props tag is actually brought to the top of this stack of tags, superseding the alphabetizing that's, you know, normally the case here. Also, the text in the script is now bold, and we see in the tags panel that we have one prop tagged. Let's select the word knapsack, and I'll tag that as a prop too. Now, look here, this refers to the word wilderness, and this might be something that we want to tag for our location scout. Notice there is actually a location tag here, which is pretty helpful. Now, I'm not going to tag this now, but if I were going to do that, I would actually probably go back to the writer, which is me, you know, I kind of blew it a little bit, but I would go back to the writer and say, hey, could you be a little bit more descriptive? Because the term wilderness is really vague. I mean, not to mention the fact that there are tons of different wilderness locations throughout the script, and that could lead to, you know, confusion and a lot of misunderstanding. Now, this next line here is a tagger's paradise. We have a black cloak, which is something the wardrobe team will need to provide. So I'll tag that as wardrobe. Dirty white dress? Oh, you know that's going to get tagged. But look here, this next thing is a little wacky. The script says that she has a dagger on her belt. So in other words, this is something that she's wearing. However, something becomes a prop once a character holds it in their hands. And later, Tayani holds this dagger. So then, the dagger is actually a prop. Although, we might want to give wardrobe the assignment of making the belt component of that, since that's kind of more in the wheelhouse of the wardrobe. So there's definitely room for coordinating between different teams for sure. The next paragraph states that dark clouds gather. We might want to tag that as a weather phenomenon so that as the first AD schedules the filming of the scene, you know, they could look out for cloudy days in the forecast or whatever. We could also tag, you know, cast members and crowds for those times that we'll need extras. I mean, you know, we could tag whatever we want here. Now, for me, I don't particularly like that tag words are just slightly bold and black. I really want them to be color-coded. So I'm going to go and color all the props purple, for example. I'll just click this little color swatch next to the props tag. Let's change this to purple here. And now all the props are purple. Let's change wardrobe to green. Same thing. And you could use whatever color system works best for you. Adobe Story also has this feature called auto tagging, which you can access by going to the top of the tags panel here. You just click it and then Story goes through and guesses and automatically tags wardrobe, props, locations, all this stuff. And, you know, for my test, it's remarkably accurate. It doesn't look at dialogue, which is really helpful. It's just super smart. I actually don't use it because I can't trust it 100%. And so then I'd have to go through the script and, you know, check every tag anyways, and that would be a lot of work, and I just prefer not to do that. So I don't use this feature, but it is still pretty amazing, and it might end up saving you a bit of time if you're a little bit more trusting. So that's the basics of breaking down and tagging a script. Note that many people still tag up their script the old school way just by using different colored highlighter pens on paper. But then, you know, you really have to keep track of what colors you're using for what items, and you can't ever change it from page to page. In Story, you just, you know, click that one swatch and everything changes. And, you know, I just really prefer doing everything digitally where possible. You know, first of all, it's less paper involved, which, you know, has both ecological and economical implications. And also, if you spend hours tagging a paper and then you lose that paper, you're stuck. And if you want to share that tagged up paper, you're stuck. Other than if you want to, you know, make really expensive color copies for every page and hand those out. It's just really not an efficient way to work. Also, once that information is put into the computer, I mean, you could organize it in so many different ways. In Story Plus, for example, I can go to the production menu, I could choose breakdown reports, and then print off reports of, you know, all cast members and which scenes they're in, or I could print a report of specific tags. So if I wanted to forward a list of all props to the art department or all the wardrobe pieces we need to the wardrobe department or whatever, I could do that with minimal effort. So I prefer to leverage my efforts by doing all this stuff digitally and in the same app, actually. But obviously use whatever method works best for you and your production when doing your script breakdown.